Hey everybody, thanks for joining us today for part number one of our new teaching devotion series called Don't Just Say It, Pray It. And today we're going to start talking about the model prayer, or as is often referred to as the Lord's Prayer. Before we get into that though, let me give you a scripture verse today, which is Luke chapter 1, verse 1. And it says this, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray. So I just have three things for you on this idea of don't just say it, pray it. First of all, I want you to understand the meaning of prayer. Jesus' disciples definitely wanted to learn how to pray the way that Jesus prayed to the Heavenly Father. And what prayer really is, it's a very interesting thing. Prayer is talking with God. A lot of times people say, well, prayer is talking to God, but that would only be a one-sided conversation. It's no fun talking to someone when one person does all the talking and no one can respond. So prayer is a conversation with God. Interestingly, the word for the word translated prayer in our English Bibles is a Greek word that actually means toward. You might think, toward, well, that doesn't have anything to do with talking with God. Actually, it does, because the idea is expressing your heart's thoughts and wants toward God. You're having a conversation with Him and expressing your heart to God. And as Christians, that's what we're to do. We're to express our heart to God, our thoughts, our desires, our concerns, and then allow God to speak back to us with what He wants us to hear and know. So that's the meaning of prayer, and this is what the disciples wanted to learn more about. Now the second thing, number two, the makeup of prayer. Now what makes prayer prayer, and what makes it genuine prayer to the Heavenly Father? Something that makes it genuine prayer is that we understand it's essential. We need to pray. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 6, verse 5, when you pray. He didn't say if you pray, He said when. It's something we must do. It's as important to our spirit as breathing is to our physical body. And then real prayer is genuine. You don't have to say some lofty prayer with these and thous and O Lord God of heaven. No, just express your heart to the Lord in your own words. Of course, it needs to be humble. We need to realize we are speaking to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And this is a great thing. It's to be continual. We're to pray at all times. The Bible says to pray without ceasing. Now, we can do that if the Holy Spirit lives within us, because then the Spirit of God within us has a continual line of communication to the Heavenly Father between us and Him. Sometimes we pray out loud, sometimes we pray silently, sometimes we pray privately, sometimes we pray in public when it's appropriate. But that's some of the things that make up genuine prayer. Then number three, I want you to notice the model prayer. This is where we really get into what the series is about. The model prayer is something that is at times known by some different names. Sometimes it's called the model prayer. Sometimes it's called the Lord's Prayer or the disciple prayer. Some churches call it the Our Father. And there are several different variations, but they're all basically the same. And so what I want to do right now is tell you the one that we're going to be using for this series. And it should be fairly familiar to you if you have been going to church for a while and been reading the Word of God. This is what the Lord's Prayer is commonly recited as. Our Father, who art in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The Lord's Prayer is a declaration of our dependence to and our relationship with God. And over the next few weeks, we're going to look at this prayer very specifically in the things that Jesus said. Because when the disciples said, Lord, teach us to pray, Jesus said, pray in this way. And He essentially taught them using a version of this model prayer or the Lord's Prayer. So it's an example and a guide for expressing our heart to God. It's not always meant to be recited, although at times we do recite it as a group, or maybe we recite it at a gathering or even before. Or bedtime when we pray, or in the morning when we get up. But more than something to recite, it's something to use as a model of how we're to communicate and express our heart to God. That's why the series is called Don't Just Say It, which sometimes we do, but we want to pray it. We want to express our heart to God with all that is within us so He can communicate back to us His love for us and His will for our lives in our day-to-day things that we're doing. So until next week, let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you. You are an amazing God worthy of praise. Thank you, Jesus, that you have given us a model or a template of prayer to help us best express our hearts towards the Heavenly Father. Thank you so much for teaching us this and helping us to learn better to pray so we can have the kind of power and do the kinds of things that you've called us to do. We love you and thank you in Jesus' name. Everybody said,